The Spiderwick Chronicles by Tony DiTerlizzi and Holly Black. Read for you by Mark Hamill. Chapter 1, in which many things are turned inside out.
What's your favorite one?
My favorite one is Wrath of Mulgrath.
Wrath, the last one?
Yep. I like the Ironwind Tree.
Uh-huh. Do you guys want to see a Spiderwick movie?
Yeah.
I can't wait.
My name is Tony DiTerlizzi. I am an artist and helped Holly Black here create Spiderwick Chronicles. This is Holly Black. Has anybody here actually read the Spiderwick Chronicles?
Wow!
We cannot tell you how incredibly excited we are to be here and to be very honored to be part of Amherst Reads' inaugural year. So I'm very, very excited.
Now, the field guide was created by their great-great-uncle, Arthur Spiderwick, and...
That's what we named the series after. Now, before we get started, does everybody here know what a field guide is?
Will?
Hey, Will, how's it going?
Good.
Are you having fun?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Was it worth the price of admission?
Yes.
Oh, well, that's good. I don't have to refund your money?
No.
Good. So, do you know what a field guide is, Will?
Yes.
Okay, can you tell everybody?
It's something that... the town is.
Tell me about
it. The town is that you see the people.
Field guide was a little different. His contained numerous paintings like this common ground goblin that he claimed he drew from real life. How you doing?
Good.
You have fun?
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to try this thing on?
Sure.
And you're positive?
Yes.
Okay.
You see, although we have the monocle, the seeing stone is not actually in place.
Finally, the director announced it was time for the first bout. He called two fencers up.
Finally, Mallory was called to the mat. Daniel something or other snickered as he put on his mask. Daniel lunged desperately, too upset to control his advance. Mallory countered, turning her defense into an attack and scoring another point. They saluted each other formally, and the boy took off his mask, red-faced and breathing hard.
If I call your name, feel free to come out and stand here at the stage.
Best costume was number 31, Marissa as Mallory.
And finally,
our
grand poobah prize of the day, the one Holly and I wished we could tackle and take off the participant.
Yes.
Goes to number 4, Evan the Dragon.
And also, you had to wear
it. Walking by, you had to wear it. And bubbles. Okay, bubbles.